pushing, and it's so effective to go deeper within it, finding those shapes. Now, having said that, you don't want to overdo it, but you know, it's kind of fun. All right, so I hope that was clear. Now, so because I'm doing all that weaving and really just playing with paint and inventing those negative shapes, that to me is making as much a statement as me trying to be a copyist and, you know, really trying to exactly copy what nature has there. I took the liberty to create some organic shapes myself, and they allow for a, you know, the essence of tree. That's what we were after, is just the essence of what this thing is. All right, so now it's time to dry that again. And some of those shapes in the painting process, some of them are they're more liquid than they really need to be. Like, I know that I don't need to stand around, I'm drawing it, because I can just use my brush like a straw. So I'll do that again. I squeegee out the brush. Now it's acting like a straw, and it just, you know, the paint vanishes. You know, it's back to the correct value as all the other shapes. I didn't have to wait so long for it all to dry. And now I'll do that. I'll assess things. I'll look, okay, now what now do I need? This is the slowing down process. This is where you fairly quickly put down a bunch of negative shapes. Now it's my job to decide how much I want to leave things alone and say those are set enough. I don't want to over detail things. So is it important to me that I hinted at that distant tree, how important it is for the piece as a whole to carry on, you know, making that go somewhere? And why I'm saying that is because you might logically think, okay, because there's a tree there, I'm now committed and must show the world that there's a tree there. Really? Like, do you really need to do that? Can that not just be a hint of a shape that, when all is said and done, is not important? What am I trying to say in the piece? I'm still after the fact that this is my main key player here. So, as far as I'm concerned right now, that main key player, he needs a more emphasis. There needs to be something to bring him out. He's a little lost still in all that plethora of shapes. So there's, as I said earlier, three, you know, main things that can help us keep our eye on that focal point. And they're going to be by way of contrasts. So the darkest darks against the lightest lights is going to work. The most brilliant colors against, you know, some real neutrals, so that it's a jewel. And also, as I said, keeping a highlight on things. So, now I'm gonna really go nuts with some color. That's a pure golden, or pardon me, orangey red. See, that's popping. Now that pure hue is making us look at this thing again. But see how I'm trying to keep the highlight The color alone is making us look at this. Excuse me. I'm gonna lay it flat now. And carry on with that idea. So, hot color, I kept the rim of where the source of light was, and I even left a little bit of untouched white paper, so it really says there's light coming through. The other tendency we can have is to, it's just an inclination we have, we don't let branches and things come in front of form, so if you don't mind me using this as an example. You might say these are lovely shapes, however, they tend to look like they're coming off the sides of the trunk and nothing is coming in front of it. You know, that's a really easy thing to forget. So don't forget to overlay and show boughs and things completely stopping that line. You know, you could pull out something there and call it a branch on top of. Or a bow, I guess is the word I should be saying, a bow on top of. And that's what this is. This is a bow that's coming across the top of the, in front of the branch, the trunk. See, now that creates depth. And here, we'll do another one here. And while that's wet and wet, create some new shadows. I could create some more color up in here. I think that's where I'll go with that. Instinctively, I feel to repeat or echo some of that beautiful color in just a few places. Like, yes, that's what's put this fella on stage, but it wouldn't hurt to echo color. Just in the odd little spot, you can just go, neep. I'm not just there. There's a little, you can see me in other little places. And that's a good thing to echo and weave. And that can sometimes just be by virtue of little droplets, like random confetti that, you know, echoes the colors. My values aren't drawn. Alright, so I would carry on finishing up this side over here the same way as I did this side. It's my call. Do I want to push back that shape? You know, when I'm in a place of indecisiveness, then that good old water media acetate comes into play. Because sometimes I just don't know. I haven't got a clue until I try it. So you can, really should be dry, but I can play with color. I can play with temperature of color. So I can experiment. Okay. Right away I say, no, that's too hot. Did I want to make it cool? You know, this is my place of not quite sure. So I'll try something. Or go even cooler. I got a feeling I should go really cool in there. I don't know why, but I'm going to try this. Yeah, see, I felt it should be cooler. Even almost to the purple. So it wouldn't be as streaky as that, but that helps me decide what to do there. And that process can take quite a while. You know, you can